Hello and welcome to the scale for Day of Destruction 13. Now we have the German Championship in Muay Thai of the WBC in the lightweight division until 61.20 kilos. Calling to the scale, Mr. Mahdi Akbari from UK Sportif Hamburg, 60.30 kilograms. His opponent is Mo Tsamtsam from Team Day of Destruction, 61.10 kilograms.
Welcome to the blue corner from UK Sportif Gym, Hamburg, Mahdi.
And yeah, now we see the first one coming in. WKF World Champion, WBC Intercontinental Champion, WBMAF World Champion, WTKA World Champion. It's Mahdi Akbari in the blue corner.
He is a very experienced fighter, as I can see.
Yeah. He's really young. He's just 20 years old, but he already has 20 fights. 17 wins, 3 losses, and 9 knockouts.
His opponent in the red corner is fighting for Team Day of Destruction. Welcome to the red corner.
And now we have Mo, who's coming from Rajsteges Gym.
Yeah, he comes from the legendary team,
Team Day of Destruction.
Of Destruction, and the legendary coach, Ralf Steger. It's Mohamed Zamzam, Palestinian born, fights for Germany now, and he's like really experienced, especially his amateur record is crazy good. He's like, to everybody fighting Muay Thai, they know the WMF Cup is in Pattaya, and it's a crazy big tournament where people all out of all of the world come to fight Muay Thai, and he won the world championship there for his weight class 2 times in a row. You gotta appreciate that. And now he's here fighting for the WBC German title, trying to make a stamp on the professional division.
So we're gonna have Waikru now.
Yeah, we have a Palestinian style Waikru on Mo's side. Yeah, he also has he told me that his main goal is not even a title or anything or an opponent. His main goal is making his family, his teammates and his coach proud. And you can see it, like even has his brother here, sitting alongside the ring and wanting to see him fight. And yeah, that's the main thing for him. He wants to make like his teammates proud. And I trained with him before. He's a nice guy. And the other opponent, I don't know that much about him, but I've seen a few fights and he has a crazy, interesting, aggressive fighting style. So
so Mo is fighting for the heart.
Round one.
I think Mahdi has problems with his
mouth
guard.
With his mouth guard, I guess.
Yeah,
yes.
Something's wrong with the mouth guard. He said he couldn't breathe, really.
So now
but
he's fine.
Too big
but
or
it's
something.
Fine now.
Okay, now we're starting. Oh, it's a feint by Mo. It's starting traditionally Muay Thai, a little bit slower. Oh, great, great punches by. Oh, and a great. Great sweep by Mo. Awesome, awesome display. He's calm, but he's controlled. Oh, great high kick, great high kick by Mahdi, and great clinching.
They go right into the clinch.
It's great. Like they're controlled and calm, but also so aggressive. This is the Muay Thai I love. Oh, but. And you can see a thing that's important to Ralf Steger, like the wing control, you know? You saw it in the last fight, from the fight of him, and now you can see it, like controlling the wing. Like Mo is always going back to the center, this clinch game.
But did you see the spin back kick from Mahdi, which is not very much like Muay Thai style, you know? It comes more from the kickboxing.
Yeah, kickboxing or Taekwondo or something. He has like a really nice style to watch. It's like action-packed style.
Mo is a very experienced with a lot of styles.
A nice high kick.
He's not just fighting Muay Thai, he did K1, boxing and MMA.
Yeah. So see, Mo is still controlling the wing, always in the center. Oh, nice sweep. Third sweep by Mo. So this is like. Mahdi has to do something. Mahdi has to get out of the. Yeah, Mahdi has to get out of the distance, like of getting clinched, because he's losing every clinch. He's losing every clinch. Every time they get close to each other, Mo is winning. Oh, nice punches. I think Mahdi should start with kicks. Otherwise, it's
Mo seems to be very concentrated and waiting for Mahdi to come out, and then he stings right into the open space.
Yeah, that's true. He's like analytical. He's really analytical. You see, he looks for holds, and when he sees them, he just takes advantage of them.
Very good low kick now.
Really good low kick. See, you can see the inside of the leg of Mahdi already being destroyed.
Already.
Yeah, it's like a man. See, and the fourth sweep or takedown.
This was like a kind of Mahdi pulls Mo down.
Yeah, but still he fell on his back, so it's most takedown or most sweep. I think Mahdi has to bring a little
better plan comes from Mo.
Yeah, Mo has a plan. He has a game plan. Yeah. You can see it. He's controlled.
But you know, in Muay Thai, things can change after the second or third round.
Yeah.
You know,
especially you know, in Muay Thai. Usually the first round. This isn't usual.
In technical fighters, they can, you know, let it flow for the first two rounds.
Yeah, yeah.
And then all of a sudden in the third round, they starting coming out, and then you can still win a fight.
Yeah, like especially in traditional Muay Thai, where they like take it slow at the beginning, maybe try to look weak, and then turn it up in the last three rounds, in the actual like point rounds. Like there's been fights where they won the first three rounds, but lost the last two, and then they lost the whole fight. So Muay Thai is a special thing with a five round system. Yeah, now it's again, how can the coaches adjust the behavior of the fighters in the break?
Again, slow started.
Yeah, and I think both fighters haven't like were training a lot before, but it's just, oh nice Superman punch by Mo. Oh wait. Now Mo's coach wants him to throw an elbow. Will we see it? But he's still waiting.
I haven't seen any elbows already.
No, it's weird because Mo is known for his elbows. If you see his other Muay Thai fights, he has like elbow knockouts, and he has like, he won his IMC championship.
Knee to the head. Fighter was down.
But
oh my God, we will see what's gonna be now.
But it's hard.
Mahdi seems to be out of control.
But you would
he got the knee right in his face.
I think that's
bad.
I don't know. Maybe that's, you never know if that's just like taking advantage of the situation, if it's really the fight.
Now. No, he's not.
Because
he's not.
I'm not sure if both see, because the coaches tell him he should stay seated. So I don't know.
Well, that came out from the action.
Yeah, the question is,
it's not a mean action from Mo. It came out from the
situation. But we need to see if there were 3 points on the ground actually, because I don't know if there were 3 points on the ground. Like he was on the ground, but not 3 points. There has to be 3 points, two knees, and a hand on the ground.
So what do you think? Is he coming back?
No, he's not, because the coach told him not to come back. So that's like they try to take advantage of the situation.
So what will the judge decide
five
now?
No, the judge is telling him. I think he told him just like give him 5 minutes. He has 5 minutes to recover. And I don't know.
No, he won't make it. I tell you, he won't make it.
Okay, it was a hard knee. But you would have to. We have videos here, so we can look at the videos. If it was
give him some applause.
There were 3 points. But it's about a championship, so I think both should fight on.
He did well so far, and it would be very sad if they won't fight
they have
anymore.
Five
if we won't
maybe
continue,
maybe he changes his mind.
But it's going to be, again, even if they will continue, it's going to be very difficult now for Mahdi. Mo is very controlled, very concentrated.
Yeah, it's like a hard situation because of the. It was really in the situation. I, from my position, couldn't see if there were 3 points on the ground or not. Could you see it?
I didn't. No.
No.
It was
okay.
Too fast. He went down and the knee came straight away.
Okay.
We have a decision now. Mr. Alessandro Sosa, the president of the WBC Germany, will end this fight by disqualification. This means the new German champion in Muay Thai of the WBC is out of the blue corner.
I'm sorry for Mo.
I'm sorry for Mo too.
This but that's the rule, that's the law.
Yeah.
Maybe they have to make a refight. What do you think?
Yeah, I think it should
they
be
have to meet again.
Because you could, like, Mo was clearly dominating this fight and it was a situational thing. It wasn't really intentional.
Sorry for Mahdi to get a win. To make a win like this. I mean,
so
I would. I'm sure he would prefer
now
to.
He's, yeah, now he gets
to,
now he gets
to go
medal,
over all, to go through all the rounds and. Make a winning of by points or by knockout, then by disqualification of his opponent.
I understand it. So now we're at a big break, and we're going to see what will happen. Mahdi is the winner. I think he's not proud of himself.